In this video, let's look at addition modulo 12. So remember that we have elements 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. So those are our only elements. Those are the only numbers we can work with. So those are the only things. So you can think of this as sort of like the numbers on a clock, except that we have replaced 12 by 0. And you'll see a little bit later in this online lesson why we have done that. Okay, so we want to know how to add two of these numbers. So let's just do some examples. So let's consider 7 plus 8. So what we want to do is really 7 plus 8 modulo 12. Right. So what do we do? Well, we first just add them in the ordinary way. So what is 7 plus 8? Well, it's 15. Right. That's just ordinary addition. But notice that 15 is not on our list. Right. It's not one of these elements, 0, 1, 2, 3, etc., up to 11. And so the way that we're going to fix it is we're going to look at this answer and say, okay, how many times does 12 go into 15? Well, in this case, it's pretty clear. 12 only goes in once. But there's a remainder. 12 doesn't go evenly into 15. There's a remainder, and the remainder is 3. 15 can be written as 12 times 1 plus 3. We've looked at how many times 12 goes evenly into 15, and the remainder is 3. 7 plus 8 mod 12, that's what we define to be 3. The mod 12 here is supposed to make you think that we're not doing ordinary addition anymore. We're now doing this modulo 12 addition, or you can think of this as kind of clock arithmetic. It's currently 7 o'clock, and in 8 hours you need to do something. Well, you could say, okay, 7 plus 8 is 15, but if you're working with just a standard clock and not military time, there is no 15 on the clock. So what do you do? Well, you say, okay, well, you look at 7 o'clock and you add 8 hours, and you notice eventually you go past 12 and it resets. Once you get to 12, it's kind of like you reset to 0, and then you go 3 more hours past 12 to get to 3 o'clock. So that's essentially the idea we're doing. But this is, in fact, this way of thinking about it here generalizes to all modular addition and modular multiplication problems. So we always add the two numbers, ask how many times 12 goes in evenly, and then look at the remainder. And the remainder is the answer. So let's do another example. So let's look at 10 plus 11 mod 12. 10 plus 11, the ordinary addition. How do you figure out 10 plus 11 mod 12? Well, you first add 10 and 11 in the ordinary way to get 21. And then you ask, how many times does 12 go into 21? So we can see that 12 goes in only once into 21. And what's the remainder? Well, it's a remainder of 9. 12 plus 9 is 21. And so when we're doing 10 plus 11 modulo 12, our answer is the remainder. You know, we take 10 plus 11, we see the sum, we divide by 12, and we take the remainder. That's the answer. So 10 plus 11 is 9. And notice that's an element in our list. Our list 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to 11. 9 is one of those elements, so that's an acceptable answer. Now let's try to add, let's say, 2 plus 3 mod 12. Again, what does our rule say? We just add 2 plus 3 in the ordinary way to get 5. And now we ask, how many times does 12 go into it? Well, 12 doesn't go any times into it. Or another way to think of it is it goes 0 times into it. If you're writing it as division by 12, 12 goes in 0 times into 5, and the remainder is 5. So 2 plus 3 can be written as 12 times 0 plus 5. 2 plus 3 can be written as 12 times 0 plus 5. And so that 5 is the remainder. We took the sum, We divide by 12, and then we take the remainder. The remainder in this case is 5. And so that's our answer. So the point is, when you add two numbers in this system, if their sum is less than 12, the answer is just the ordinary sum. So the modular sum and the ordinary sum coincide when the sum of the two numbers is less than 12. When the answer is greater than 12, then we have to divide and take the remainder. But what we've just seen in this case is that we can always think of it as dividing and taking the remainder. It's just that when the sum, like in this case, 2 plus 3, when the sum is less than 12, we're always going to get, it's always just going to match the answer we would get from just ordinary addition. But it's the same way that you do it every single time. And so let's do one more of these. What would 3 plus 4 mod 12 be? Well, we know that ordinary addition of 3 plus 4 would be 7. 7 is less than 12. So if we tried to divide by 12, it would only go in 0 times, and the remainder would be 7. So here we can just automatically say it's 7. Okay? So now,